فؤادك الأيام فتى.
The Prophet himself, what did he say? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, what did he say? قل لو كنت أعلم الغيب, if I knew the unseen, لاستكثرت من الخير وما مسني السوء. If I knew the unseen, harm would not have touched me, and I would have done a lot of good. And you see the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a noble companion died, I think he was Uthman ibn Mad'un, I think it was him, he died. And then the people, they started to praise Uthman ibn Mat'un. And they were saying Uthman is in Jannah. And Uthman is the righteous man. And they started to say that and praise him. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked at them and he said, Ana Rasulullah. I am the Messenger of Allah. Wala a'lamu ma yuf'alu bi. I am the Messenger of Allah. And I don't know what is going to be done to him. I don't know. I'm the Messenger of Allah. I don't even know where he is. I don't know where he's going. So that shows you our Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. Some people went extreme with him after his death, alayhi salatu wasalam. And they took a path in which the Prophet would have said, Ma uhibbu, I don't love. And tarfa'uni, to uplift me. Fawqa manzilati allati anzalani Allahu. I don't want you guys to take me above the status that Allah gave me. What was the status that Allah gave him? He is abd, he's a slave. What's his status? What is the status that Allah gave him? He's a abd, a slave. He's a rasul, he's a messenger. وَقَدْ عَقَدَ الْمُصَنِّفُ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ لِذَٰلِكَ بَابًا فِي كِتَابِ التَّوْحِيدِ. And the author, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, he designated a chapter in his book, Kitab al-Tawheed. He called it what? بَابُ the chapter. مَا جَاءَ that which has come. في حماية المصطفى, the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم safeguarding and protecting. حما التوحيد, safeguarding the boundaries of the توحيد. وسد طرق الشرك, and also barricading and blocking off the path to shirk. So there was already a chapter like that in his tome. There's already a chapter like that in what? In كتابه التوحيد. He already did that. He spoke about it there. وكما, and also now we're going to carry on Ibn Uthaymeen's explanation. وكما بين الله تعالى الإخلاص وأظهره, and the same way بين الله, Allah clarified الإخلاص, sincerity, وأظهره, and Allah made it apparent. Allah clarified, He explained to us in the Quran sincerity, and also what did Allah do? بين ضده, and Allah also clarified to us the opposite to it, which is what? وَهُوَ الشِّرْكُ, which is shirk. فَقَالَ تَعَالَى, Allah said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ, Allah is not one that forgives. أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ, for him to be associated partners with him. وَيَغْفِرُ, and Allah forgives. مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ, anything that is beside that. لِمَن يَشَاءُ, whoever he wills. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى, Allah also says, وَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ, worship Allah. وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا, and do not associate him with partners at all. Because we took, if a la, after it comes a what? A nakiratun, an indefinite, what does it show? فَتَعُمْ, it shows generalization. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى, and Allah also said, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا, we have sent, فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ, in every nation, رَسُولًا, a messenger. What was the messenger's message? أَنِ اعْبُدُ اللَّهَ, worship Allah. وَجْتَنِبُوا, stay away from what? الطَّاغُوتَ, stay away from the طَاغُوت. طَاغُوت is everything that is worshipped besides Allah, and he's pleased with it. وَالْآيَاتُ فِي ذَٰلِكَ كَثِيرَةٌ, and the verses that are in this matter are a lot. The verses that are pertaining to what? In clarifying the Tawheed. Are you with me? The verses that have come regarding clarifying the Tawheed and making obligatory on everyone to come with ikhlas in the worship of Allah, and also to clarify shirk and to warn against it. There are a lot in the Quran. They are what? A lot. So the verses that talk about Tawheed and the importance of Tawheed and to come with Tawheed, they're excessive. And the second thing, which is the verses that talk about shirk, and the and warn against shirk and to speak about its dangers and its consequences are also a lot. وَيَقُولُ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ And the messenger said, مَنْ لَقِيَ اللَّهَ Anyone who meets Allah, لَا يُشْرِكْ بِهِ شَيْئًا And does not associate him with partners, دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ Anyone who meets Allah, the Day of Judgment, and he has not associated Allah with partners, he will enter Jannah or she will enter Jannah. وَمَنْ لَقِيَهُ Anyone who meets Allah, يُشْرِكْ بِهِ شَيْئًا And he has associated partners with Allah. دخل النار. He will enter the hellfire. رواه مسلم من حديث جابر. Imam Muslim, he narrated it من حديث جابر رضي الله تعالى عنه. The hadith is in Sahihain من حديث عبد الله بن مسعود as well. عبد الله بن مسعود narrated it and it's in Bukhari and Muslim. But what it says in this hadith is مَنْ لَقِيَ اللَّهَ لَا يُشْرِكْ بِهِ شَيْءٍ دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ وَمَنْ لَقِيَهُ يُشْرِكْ بِهِ شَيْءٍ دَخَلَ النَّارَ Abdullah ibn Mas'ud in Sahihain when he narrated the hadith مَنْ مَاتَ Anyone who dies يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ شَيْءٍ دَخَلَ النَّارَ Abdullah ibn Mas'ud he said that the Prophet said Anyone who dies associating partners with Allah will enter the hellfire After Abdullah ibn Mas'ud narrated that hadith of the Prophet he said وقلت أنا القائل Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said I am the one who said من مات the one who dies لا يشرك بالله شيئا دخل الجنة The opposite Because the Prophet didn't mention the opposite The Prophet only mentioned shirk The Prophet only said من مات anyone who dies يشرك بالله شيئا دخل النار Anyone who dies associating partners with Allah will enter the hellfire That's what the Prophet said But Abdullah ibn Mas'ud he understood from it what مفهوم المخالفة He understood the opposite from it which is the one who dies and does not associate partners with Allah will enter Jannah. And that shows us that the Sahabas, they used to see the evidence in the mafoom, the dalalatul mafoom, if it can be implemented. As they used to see that, of course, without a doubt, that the mantuq, and we spoke about that in our sharah of Risalatul Latifa. وَالشِّرْكُ عَلَى نَوْعَيْنِ Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen says that shirk is of two types. Before we go into the shirk, It's important, inshallah ta'ala, we take that then, what's the meaning of shirk? Shirk has come in many, many meanings in the language. Many meanings. And I'm going to tell you each one, inshallah ta'ala. The first meaning that the shirk has come in, this is not in the Sharh ibn Uthaymeen, rahimahullah ta'ala. Just a side benefit, write this down. The shirk linguistically has come in many meanings. First one it came is, الاشتراك في الشيء بين اثنين فصاعدا. It is to associate in a matter between two or more. And the evidence for that is the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ said, he said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, المسلمون, the believers are what? شركاء. The Muslims, they share in three things. Three things we Muslims share. No one's got right over there, no one over it. We all share this, it's a common right. Al-ma, water. Water is owned by everybody. No one can claim, this is my water, I'll sell it to you. Like, water generally is owned by what? By everyone. If you come to a place where there's a river running, you can't stop the people from drinking from it. It's owned by everyone. It's shared. The second one is, wal-kala, the grass, the green grass. No one can claim, of course, Rulings differ here. Of course, if the person owns the land, he bought the land, he put a fence behind it, then it's his. If the person bottled the water and he put effort in cleaning the water and he brought it to the people, he can charge. That's not what we're talking about. Speaking about open land where you found water, you see, you can't charge the people for it. But if you've taken a machine and you plugged it in and to bring the water out and you went, you can charge, no problem. Wal-kala and the grass, no one owns it. The Muslims all share this together. Wanari, the fire. Fire isn't something is yours. You don't own fire. Are you with me? And based on that, some of the fuqaha, they took if a person asks you for fire, because in countries like Africa, they don't have these cookers that they cook with. The people, what they do is, they have charcoals, they burn the charcoal when they're cooking, and then later what they do is, the ashes that come from it, they bury the charcoal, and that fire doesn't die out. And in the morning, all they do is just they just start and it comes back. Sometimes what happens is they don't bury it very well. They don't bury it what? Very well. And because they haven't buried it very well, what happens is in the morning you'd have to go ask for people to give you fire. Some of the fuqaha take that you have to give it to them because the fire is actually not yours. So you have to. They take your charcoal and they take their charcoal and they stick it together and they blow over it for about a bit and then the fire goes into the other one and they give you back your one and they start using it like that. So the evidence in this hadith is what? That the word shirk in the language, it means what? Sharing between two or more is called shirk. Okay. Also, the other meaning that the word shirk has is what? Taswiya to shay'i bighayrihi. Also, the other meaning is to make equal things between one another. You say this is the same as this. It's to make things equal one another and to make them same. The third meaning that it comes in is what? Is al-hissat wal-naseeb, a portion. A portion. It's also called a what? For example, what Allah said in the Surah to Saba, وَمَا لَهُمْ فِيهِمَا مِنْ شِرْكٍ. And they do not have in it any naseeb, a portion of it. Also, the meaning that it comes in the language is al-khaltu wa-dhammu. When you mix two things. Or you bring two things together that were separated, you bring them together. It's called shirk. So if you take milk and you add water to it, you've mixed water with shirk. And many other meanings that it comes in. Many other meanings. How many types are there? There are two types. Shirk, which is akbar, and shirk, which is asghar, the shirk is going to mention to us, inshallah ta'ala. But the best definition that goes to both of them is, if somebody asked you, what is the difference between shirk akbar and asghar? Hey, faddal, what's the difference? Hey, Shia Abdullah, what's the difference between shirk akbar and shirk asghar? So the young one, is the smaller, doesn't make you a disbeliever. So for Shirk Asghar, you're not going to be in hellfire forever. For Shirk Asghar. Hey, when Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala said in the Quran, إِنَّهُمْ مَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ وَمَأْوَاهُ النَّارِ وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارِ. Allah said shirk, جَنُّون. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَنْ يُشْرَكَ. Allah does not forgive the one who does shirk. Where have you got the big one and the minor one and all of that? Here Allah just said shirk. Yeah.
Probably one is when you make equal. The other one is when you just mention, like for example, an actual ibadah. You mention something.
It's showing off shirk.
Yeah.
Is it minor or major?
Minor.
So then isn't that sharing Allah with something, showing off? Huh? Hey, Sa'ad, talk.
But the verse you mentioned, one shirk ever comes, it's never mine.
So exactly. So why have you said that this is the only? It's only referring to the major one.
What's the verse before it?
The verse before it is Isa ibn Maryam telling these people that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will not forgive you for shirk.
There's no context given.
Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah took that. It's all of it, minor and major. This is important. Many people don't really understand it. So what do you mean it leads to it? What leads to it? What do you mean leads to it? Like how does it? The best meaning, the best meaning is shirkul asghar, shirkul akbar, sorry, it goes against the asl of iman. It would strip you from the asl of the iman. Your original essence of your iman goes. Are you with me? Whereas shirkul akbar, it goes against other than the asl of the iman. goes against your kamaluhu al-wajib. It goes against your kamaluhu al-wajib. When we talk about iman, we said the iman is divided into how much? Aslul iman, kamaluhu al-wajib, kamaluhu al-mustahab. Are you with me? So, shirk al-akbar goes against what? Shirk al-akbar yunafi tawhida min aslihi. Shirk al-akbar, it negates the asl of the iman. Meaning, once you've done it, you're a disbeliever. Whereas, which shirk al-asghar, what does it go against? It goes against your kamaluhu al-wajib. Kamaluhu al-wajib. So the person is what? Still a believer. He's still a? Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen is going to explain that to us. النوع الأول, the first time. شرك الأكبر, it's a major shirk. مخرج عن الملة, it will take you out of the religion. وهو, and it is, كل شرك, every shirk. أطلقه الشارع, the legislator. Mentions unrestrictedly. وهو منافع للتوحيد, and it negates your توحيد. منافاة مطلقة, it negates your iman, your tawheed, unrestrictedly. Meaning it takes it all. It will all go. So this one is what? فهذا مخرج من الملة. This is the one that takes you out of the religion. مثل, like, أن يصرف شيئا من أنواع العبادة لغير الله. It is that the person diverts a type of the ibadat for other than Allah. He diverts it from Allah to other than Allah. For example, بأن يصلي لغير الله. For example, he prays for other than Allah. أو يذبح لغير الله. Or he slaughters for other than Allah. أو ينذر لغير الله. Or he makes an oath for other than Allah. أو أن يدعو غير الله. Or he calls on to other than Allah. مثل, like, for example, أن يدعو صاحب قبر. For example, he calls on to a person in the grave. أو يدعو غائبا. Or he calls on to a person who's absent. Even if he's alive, but he's absent. أو يدعو غائبا لإنقاذه, so he can save you. He can save you من أمر, from a matter لا يقدر عليه إلا الحاضر. No one else can help you in this matter except a person who is present. وأنواع الشرك معلومة فيما كتبه أهل العلم. And the types of shirk are known in regards to the scholars have written regarding this matter. Meaning the scholars have written regarding this matter. Scholars have mentioned that. النَّوْعُ الثَّانِي, the second type. The second type is الشِّرْكُ الْأَصْغَرُ, the minor shirk. وَهُوَ, and it is كُلُّ عَمَلٍ, every action. قَوْلِيٍ, utterance. Every action by way of utterance. أو فعليين, or by way of action. أطلق عليه الشارع, in which the legislator, he described it, وصف الشرك, that the شارع referred to it as shirk. لكنه, but, لا ينافي التوحيد منافاة مطلقة, but it does not negate the توحيد, a negation which is unrestricted. مثل, for example, الحلف بغير الله, swearing by other than Allah. فالحالف بغير الله, because the one who swears by other than Allah. الذي لا يعتقد, who doesn't believe, أن لغير الله تعالى من العظمة. He believes that other than Allah, other than Allah, doesn't deserve honoring. ما يماثل عظمة الله, that which is equal to the honoring of Allah. مشرك شرك الأصغر. This person has done a shirk asghar. Pay attention. He is swearing by other than Allah, right? Is he not? He's swearing by other than Allah. But swearing by other than Allah, isn't that you honoring a person, a creation, other than Allah, isn't it? It is. But he doesn't believe that. If he does believe it, what does it turn into? Shirk Akbar. But he doesn't believe that. He's swearing by other than Allah, he is? It's Shirk Asghar. Because when you ask him, he says, what are you doing? He will say to you what? Akhi, I know Allah is the only one. But still doesn't stop him from falling into shirk asghar. But if he says, yeah, I know, I'm honoring these people as much as I honor Allah, he fell into what? Shirk akbar. وَمِثْلُ الرِّيَاءِ, and also showing off. وَهُوَ خَطِيرٌ and it's very dangerous. قَالَ فِيهِ النَّبِيُّ the messenger said. It's very dangerous, this type of shirk. قَالَ فِيهِ النَّبِيُّ the prophet said, أَخْوَفُ مَا أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمُ الشِّرْكُ الْأَصْغَرُ I fear for you, that which I fear for you is الشِّرْكُ الْأَصْغَرُ I fear for you. فَسُئِلَ عَنْهُ the messenger was asked, and then he said, الرِّيَاءُ showing off. Imam Ahmad ibn Abi Dunya Bayhaqi in his Zuhd, they narrated it from the narration of Mahmud ibn Labid radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The most comprehensive definition of Shirk al-Asghar is as follows, or how to identify it. This is the best way. Shirk al-Asghar is everything that the Sharia prohibited. Are you with me? It's everything that the Sharia what? It prohibited. Which is a means to Shirk al-Akbar. It's a means to get to Shirk al-Akbar. And the Sharia also called it Shirk. The Sharia called it a what? It called it a shirk. So what does it have to be? The Sharia has to, first of all, number one, the Sharia has to prohibit it. Number two, it has to be something that will lead you to shirk al-asghar. Akbar, sorry. It will lead you to what? Shirk al-akbar. And the third thing is what? The Sharia called it shirk. Good. Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen again. وَقَدْ يَصِلُ الرِّيَاءُ إِلَى الشِّرْكِ الْأَكْبَرِ The showing off can lead you to إِلَى الشِّرْكِ الْأَكْبَرِ It can lead you to the major shirk. وَقَدْ مَثَّلَ ابْنُ الْقَيِّمِ Ibn al-Qayyim, he gave it an example, رحمه الله, للشرك الأصغري. Ibn al-Qayyim, he gave an example to الشرك الأصغر. بِيَسِيرِ الرِّيَاءِ The little showing off. وَهَذَا يَدُلُّ This shows. That shows. Ibn al-Qayyim said, when he spoke about minor shirk, he said that it's the minor showing off. Because the major showing off is shirk akbar. وَهَذَا يَدُلُّ And this shows. عَلَى أَنَّ كَثِيرَ الرِّيَاءَ قَدْ يَصِلُ إِلَى الشِّرْكِ الْأَكْبَرِ That if the showing becomes a lot, it can become shirk akbar. Pay attention. وَقَدْ ذَهَبَ بَعْضُ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ Some of the scholars, they took. إلى أن قوله تعالى that the statement of Allah إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك به Allah will not forgive the one who does shirk for him يشمل it consists of كل شرك every type of shirk ولو كان أصغر even if it's little and one of the people that held that view was who as I said Ibn Taymiyyah that ayah إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك به also the minor falls under it why because Allah تبارك وتعالى what did he say إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك and Allah تبارك وتعالى spoke general and he did not give any restriction and he did not say أصغر so Ibn Taymiyyah said that they both fall under it فالواجب what is obligatory is Ibn Uthaymeen says الحذر من الشرك مطلقا that the person he is cautious from shirk unrestrictedly Don't worry and say to yourself, it's minor. No. Stay away from it. Na'am. فَإِنَّ عَاقِبَتَهُ وَخِيمَةٌ Its consequences is bad. عَاقِبَةٌ means consequences. وَخِيمَةٌ means it's bad. وَخِيمَةٌ means something bad. قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى Allah said, إِنَّهُ مَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ The one who associates partners with Allah. فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ Allah has prohibited from him. Al-Jannah. Jannah Allah has prohibited from you. Wa ma'wahu an-nar. And the hellfire is your abode. Wa ma lil-zalimin min ansar. And the transgressors and the oppressive and the criminals who have fallen into shirk, they don't have no one giving them victory. They have no ansar, supporters that day. So the one you're doing the shirk for, he won't help you. He's not going to be a nasir for you that day. Fa'idha hurimatil jannatu ala al-mushrikeen. So if Jannah was made haram from the one who has fallen into shirk, lazima, then what is necessary is أن يكون خالداً في النار that he is in the hellfire forever. في النار أبداً. That he is in the hellfire there forever. فالمشرك بالله تعالى The one who associates partners with Allah. قَدْ خَسِرَ الْآخِرَةَ فَالْمُشْرِكُ بِاللَّهِ. The one who associates partners with Allah Ta'ala. قَدْ خَسِرَ الْآخِرَةَ. He has lost the hereafter. لَا رَيْبَ. Without a doubt. لِأَنَّهُ فِي النَّارِ خَالِدًا. Because he's in the hellfire forever. وَخَسِرَ الدُّنْيَا. And he's also lost the dunya. لِأَنَّهُ because مَا قَامَتْ عَلَيْهِ الْحُجَّةِ. لِأَنَّهُ قَامَتْ عَلَيْهِ الْحُجَّةِ. Because this proof was established on him. وَجَاءَهُ النَّذِيرُ. The warner came to him. وَلَكِنَّهُ خَسِرَ. But he has lost. لَمْ يَسْتَفِدْ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا شَيْئًا. He did not benefit from this dunya anything. قَالَ تَعَالَى. Allah says, قُلْ إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Verily those who are lost are الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. They are the ones who lost themselves. They destroyed themselves. وَأَهْلِيهِمْ. And their families, the day of judgment. They've led them to destruction. أَلَا ذَلِكَ وَالْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينَ. That is the true loss a person can go through. So many people, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala saying, lost is really what? A loss is really what? You know, I was reading the news the other day. And guess what? They say that in this country, one of the richest men in this country recently, is a billionaire. He had a big bill, he had a company, big company. He had a what? He had a big company. The son killed himself. He threw himself from a building. Have you guys seen, heard it? Recently, he threw himself from a building and they found him outside. It's in London. Rich guy. Rich family. I think they're originally Indian, but extremely rich. Billionaires. They had a big company. I forgot the name. So why? It's ayah. قُلْ إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَلِيهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَلَا ذَلِكَ وَالْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينَ. Because in this dunya, he didn't have tawheed with him. The warner came to him. The proof was there. But what? He turned away. And in the hereafter, he's destroyed himself. He's destroyed his family. And then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says to him, that is a clear loss. The business you lost was nothing. The true loss is the person who loses tawheed. أَلَا ذَلِكَ وَالْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينَ. Ibn Uthaymeen says, فَخَسِرَ نَفْسَهُ. He destroyed himself. لِأَنَّهُ لَمْ يَسْتَفِدْ مِنْهَا شَيْئًا. Because he didn't benefit anything from it. وَأُرَدَّهَا النَّارِ. And he brought it to the hellfire. He what? He brought himself to the hellfire. وَبِئْسَ الْوِرْدُ الْمَوْرُودِ. And the evilest place to go to is the hellfire. وَخَسِرَ أَهْلَهُ. And he destroyed his family. لأنهم إن كانوا مؤمنين. If they were believers, فهم في الجنة. They are in Jannah. فلا يتمتع بهم. He's not going to enjoy them. وإن كانوا في النار. And if they are in the hellfire, فكذلك. And like that, he's not going to enjoy his own family. لأنه كلما دخلت أمة لعنت أختها. The people in the hellfire, you and your wife who are both going to the hellfire, or you and you're not going to enjoy each other. You know why? Because every time a group of people enter the hellfire, they curse the ones that will come after them. As Allah said, كلما دخلت أمة لعنت أختها. Every time a group enter, they start cursing the previous ones. They're like, why are you squeezing us in here? وَعْلَمْنَا أَنَّ الشِّرْكَ خَفِيٌّ جِدًّا. Shirk is very hidden. وَقَدْ خَافَهُ خَلِيلُ الرَّحْمَانِ. The close friend of Allah, Nabiullah Ibrahim, feared it. وَإِمَامُ الْحُنَفَاءِ. And he is the leaders of those who've diverted from shirk. كَمَا حَكَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. As Allah has informed us in his affairs about Nabiullah Ibrahim. What did he say? وَجْنُبْنِي وَبَنِيَّ أَنْ نَعْبُدَ الْأَصْنَامِ. Oh Allah, divert myself and my children to worship in idols. وَتَأَمَّلْ. Ibn Uthaymeen said, look, observe. قَوْلُهُ. The statement of Ibrahim, which is what? وَجْنُبْنِي. Oh Allah, divert me. وَلَمْ يَقُلْ. He didn't say, وَمْنَعْنِي. Stop me from it. Because he said, لِأَنَّ إِجْنُبْنِي. Because the word إِجْنُبْنِي, what does it carry? أَيْجْعَلْنِي فِي جَانِبِ عِبَادَةِ. It means what? The word إِجْنُبْنِي means what? Make me on a on the other side. Stop me from it is when you've already come to it. Ijnubni means what? Where you make shirk, make me on the other side of it. Ij'alni fi janibi ibadah, make me on the side of ibadah. Wal asnama fi janibin, and also make idol worshippers and idol worshipping on another side. Separate me from it. And that is far more eloquent. وَهَذَا أَبْلَغُ And that is far more eloquent and more powerful than the meaning of the word imna'ni and prevent me from. لِأَنَّهُ Because إِذَا كَانَ فِي جَانِبٍ وَهِيَ فِي جَانِبٍ كَانَ أَبْعَدُ Because if you are in one place and idol worshipping is another place, you're far from it. نعم. وَقَالَ ابْنَ أَبِي مُلَيْكَ And Ibn Abi Mulaika, he said, أدركت, I met 30 من أصحاب رسول الله, the companions of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. I met 30 of them. كلهم, all of them, يخافوا النفاق. They were all scared of hypocrisy على نفسه, on themselves. I met 30 of the companions of the Messenger. Each and every one of them was scared of hypocrisy. That statement, Imam al-Bukhari narrated in his Kitab al-Iman. And the chapter he brought it in is very powerful. He brought it in the chapter بَابُ خَوْفُ الْمُؤْمِنِ مِنْ أَنْ يَحْبِطَ عَمَلُهُ وَهُوَ يَشْعُرُ وَهُوَ لَا يَشْعُرُ He brought it in a chapter of the believer being scared. Bukhari, it is a wisdom why he brought it under that chapter. He brought it under chapter which is, he brought it in Kitab al-Iman number one. And then that's in the book he brought it in. And then in the chapter, he called it the chapter of the believer being scared. That his actions nullify and he doesn't know. Scare you. These actions can nullify, you can be committing shirk and you don't know. Allahu Akbar. And then he brought the statement straight away. Who did he bring? Imam al-Bukhari. He brought the statement of Qawlu Ibrahim al-Taymi. Ibrahim al-Taymi. What did he say? Ma aradtu qawli ala amali. I haven't presented my speech to my actions, illa khashitu, except I got scared, an akuna mukadhiban, I got scared that I might be a liar, and I will be said to that you're a liar. And the statement of Hassan al-Basri, in which he said, ma akhafuhu. Sorry, Hassan al-Basri said, مَا خَافَهُ No one fears hypocrisy إِلَّا مُؤْمِنٌ Except a believer. وَلَا أَمَنَهُ And no one finds safety from hypocrisy إِلَّا مُنَافِقٌ Except he's a munafiq. Ibn Uthaymeen says, وَقَالَ أَمِيرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ عُمَرْ بْنُ الْخَطَّابِ عُمَرْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ He said to حُذَيْفَةَ بْنُ الْيَمَانِ Ibn Uthaymeen said it. That Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said to Hudhayfah ibn al-Yaman, Anshuduka Allah, I swear you by Allah, Hal sammani anshuduka Allah, I swear you by Allah, Hal sammani laka Rasulullah, did the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mention me, ma'a man samma min al-munafiqeena, from those in which he has mentioned from the hypocrites. Umar ibn al-Khattab is scared for what? فَيَخْشَى فَارُوقُ هَذِي الْأُمَّةِ عُمَرُ بْنُ الْخَطَّابِ is scared for what? عَلَى نَفْسِ أَنْ يَكُولَ مُنَافِقًا He's scared that he might be a hypocrite, Umar. He said to حُذَيْفَةَ بْنُ الْيَمَانِ أَنْشُدُكَ اللَّهِ I swear by Allah. هَلْ سَمَّانِ لَكَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ Has the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned me amongst the hypocrites مَعَ مَنْ سَمَّى مِنَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen says after that, مَعَ أَنَّ رَسُولَ Even that though the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam basharahu bil Jannah, even that though the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave Umar glad tidings of Jannah, walakinahu khafa, but Umar radiallahu anhu is scared, an yakuna dhalika, walakinahu khafa, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu got scared, an yakuna dhalika lima dhahar, he's scared because the Prophet only judged him on that which was apparent. لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من أفعالي في حياتي While the Prophet was alive, that which was apparent at that time, he thinks now things have probably changed in his heart and he's scared, رضي الله تعالى عنه والله no one, Ibn Uthaymeen said فلا يأمن النفاق إلا منافقون That's a statement of Hassan al-Basri that I brought before فلا يأمن النفاق إلا منافق. No one finds safety from hypocrisy except he's a hypocrite. ولا يخاف النفاق, and no one fears hypocrisy, إلا مؤمن except he's a believer. فعلى العبد, Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen said, it's upon the servant, أن يحرص على الإخلاص, that he always strives to sincerity. وأن يجاهد نفسه عليه, and that he fights his soul in regards to that matter. قال بعض السلف, some of the pious predecessors, they said, ما جاهدت نفسي على شيء, I have never fought, ما جاهدت نفسي, I have never fought myself على شيء, أي matter, ما جاهدتها على الإخلاص. The way I fought with myself in terms with sincerity, the way I fought with myself in regards to sincerity, I've never fought to myself in any other way. فالشرك, Ibn Uthaymeen said, shirk is أمر صعب جدا. Shirk is a matter that is difficult. ليس بالهين, it is not an easy matter. هين, it's not easy. ولكن الله يبشر الإخلاص على العبد. ولكن الله ييسر الإخلاص على العبد. But Allah makes sincerity easy upon the servant. وذلك, and that is, بأن يجعل الله له, يجعل الله, and that is by Allah making him, وذلك, and that is, بأن يجعل الله, and that is for him to make Allah, نصب عينيه, in front of his eyes. نصب means in front of his own eyes. فيقصد بعمله وجه الله, and that he intends Allah in his actions. Wallahi, a person should stay away from showing off. And people see your actions. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to make dua and he used to say this, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika an ushrika bika wa ana a'lamu wa astaghfiruka lima la a'lamu. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, oh Allah, I seek refuge in you for me to associate you in part with partners, and I know when I'm doing it, and I ask you for forgiveness in that which I don't know. Ibn Abi Shayba narrated that in his Musannaf. Abu Ya'la narrated that. Bukhari narrated in Adab al-Mufrad. Shaykh al-Albani authenticated it. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, يَعْرِفُونَ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ, they know the blessings of Allah. ثُمَّ يُنْكِرُونَهَا, and then they reject it. وَأَكْثَرُهُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ, and the majority of them are disbelievers. When Mujahid commented on that verse, which is the 83rd verse in Surah An-Nahl, ayah 83, when Mujahid commented on that verse, he said, "Huwa qawlu ar-rajul," it is the statement of a man saying, "Hadha mali," this is my wealth, "warithtuhu min an abai," this is my wealth, I inherited it from my forefathers. The ayah is saying, "Ya'rifuna ni'mat Allah," they know the blessings of Allah. And then after that, they reject it, and the majority of them are disbelievers. Mujahid said that the way that they reject it means that they say, this is my wealth, I inherited it from my forefathers, that's where I got it from. Aun ibn Abdullah, he said, Aun ibn Abdullah, he said, يقولون, they would say, لولا فلان لم يكن كذا. Aun ibn Abdullah, he said, the way they reject the blessings of Allah is, they would say, if it wasn't for so and so, the matter wouldn't have been like this. That is how they reject the blessings of Allah. Ibn Qutayba, he said, يَعْرِفُونَ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ يُنْكِرُونَهَا, means they would say, هَذَا بِشَفَعَةِ آلِهَتِنَا, this is the intercession of our idols, or whatever anyone worships. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah brought all those statements in Majmu' al-Fatawa. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he brought a benefit from a hadith, so inshallah ta'ala, we're going to mention it to conclude it with this chapter, inshallah ta'ala. I hope you guys can pay attention. It's a bit long, but I will read it on you guys. It's of benefit. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah brought the hadith of Zayd ibn Khalid radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he led the prayer one day. Salla lana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Messenger led us the prayer, and the salah that the Prophet led here was the Fajr prayer, the Subh prayer, and he led them in Hudaybiyah, the place Hudaybiyah. The Messenger led them. Ala ithri sama'in kanat min al-layl, when there was a thing in the sky that just took place, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam led the Sahabas. فَلَمَّا انصَرَفَ أَقْبَلَ عَلَى النَّاسِ When the Prophet prayed and he finished the prayer, he looked at the people and he looked at them. This is Fajr. And he looked at the people, he said, هَلْ تَدْرُونَ مَاذَا قَالَ رَبُّكُمْ Do you guys know what your Lord just said? And then they said, Allah wa Rasulu a'lam, Allah and His Messenger know. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, أَصْبَحَ مِنْ عِبَادِي This morning from my servants they have come a group who are mu'minun bi, a group of them who are a believers in me, wa kafirun, mu'minun bi wa kafirun, a group who are believers in me and a disbeliever. فَأَمَّا مَنْ قَالَ As for the one who says, مُطِرْنَا بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَرَحْمَتِهِ The rain that came down from the sky and that which was sent down on us, and that cloud and the rain that came, we were given it with the virtue of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That rain that we got, those who said that we got it with Allah's mercy and His virtue, فَذَٰلِكَ مُؤْمِنٌ بِي Those are the believers who believe in me. كَافِرٌ بِالْكَوْكَبِ And they are disbelievers of the, they are the disbelievers of the stars. Those who say that, or who bring the second party, the Prophet. وَأَمَّا مَنْ قَالَ And those who say, مُطِرْنَا It rained based on what? بِنَوْءِ كَذَا وَكَذَا Based on the star of this star was there and it moved from there and it rained because of that. Those who said, فَذَلِكَ كَافِرٌ بِي Those are disbelievers of me. مُؤْمِنٌ بِالْكَوْكَبِ And they are believers of the stars. Those They are disbelievers of those. Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim narrated this hadith, Abu Dawood al-Nasa'i, Malik in Muwatta, Shafi'i in his Musnad, Ahmad ibn Hanbal in his Musnad, Ibn Hibban in his Sahih, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said, وَهَذَا كَثِيرٌ فِي الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ That is a lot in the book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger. يَذُمُّ سُبْحَانَهُ Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala rebukes مَنْ يُضِيفُ إِنْعَامَهُ تَعَالَى إِلَى غَيْرِهِ Anyone who attributes to Allah the blessings that He has given to other than Him, وَيُشْرِكُ بِهِ And who associates partners with Him. قَالَ بَعْضُ السَّلَفِ Ibn Taymiyyah said that some of the pious predecessors, they said, هُوَ كَقَوْلِهِمْ كَانَتِ الرِّيحُ طَيِّبَةً وَالْمَلَّاحُ حَاذِقًا Some people, it's like the speeches of the pre-Islamic people, they used to say, or the Arabs, they say, the wind was very good, and the guy who was riding the boat for us and who was controlling the boat, he knew what he was doing. Like a lot of people say, Akhi, mashallah, you got us there safely. Wallahi, you were a good driver. And the weather was good today. That's what some people say. فَوَصَلْنَا الْبَرَّ بِسَلَامَةٍ وَأَمَانٍ Because of your good driving of the boat and also the wind being good, we got safely to the shore. Instead of saying, Allah brought us, they don't do that. They don't attribute it to Allah. وَكَمَا يَقُولُ فِي نَحْوِ ذَلِكَ مِمَّا هُوَ جَارٍ عَلَى أَلْسِنَةٍ كَثِيرٍ And he said, Ibn Utaymiyyah, he goes, it's a benefit, this kalam, wallahi. And as a lot of people say, which is common on their tongues, they ascribe a matter to the reason, not to the one who made the reason happen. And they forget the Creator. What does it mean, the reason? Naam, the good wind and the driver are only the means. Why are you placing the benefit on them or the blessing on them? They're just the means. All of that can be in place and Allah can still turn over your boat. Subhanahu wa ta'ala.